Hi, I'm Bill Griffith, an application engineer with Agilent Technologies. Today, I want to talk about synchronizing the output of a two-channel waveform generator. This is necessary when you want to simulate two signals that are correlated in time. An example of this is two clock signals. Even if they're different frequencies, if they come from the same source, they'll be correlated in time. So let's get started. When we first start the waveform generator in its default mode, the two channels work independently. We can set up different waveforms on each channel. We can have different amplitudes and different frequencies. I've chosen the same frequencies for these signals, and at this point, they're not phase aligned. And so what we need to do is we need to go into our phase menu and choose sync internal. Now the waveforms are aligned in phase, and we can put a phase offset in if we want to at this point from the same menu. We have some additional methods to align the waveforms as well. The problem with this method is if we change the frequency, so I'm going to go to 2 kilohertz on channel 2, is that we'll lose our phase alignment and we'll have to go back into the menu and align it one more time. And so anytime we change the frequency, we have to realign it. So let's look at some other methods for aligning the phase. Okay, method number 2. Let's say we have 2 clock signals and they're a ratio of 3:1. What we can do is we can use channel coupling to go ahead and set that up. So I'm going to go ahead and turn on frequency coupling, and then I'm going to set the ratio of 3:1. And now, as you can see, for every period of our first signal, we'll get 3 periods of our second signal. We can go ahead and synchronize them so they start with zero phase again, just like we did before. Okay, and now when I adjust the frequency of channel 1, you'll notice that channel 2 adjusts along with it and they stay in phase as well. So this is a unique feature of the 33500 series waveform generator. And another thing we can do with our frequency coupling is we could use an offset instead. Right now we're using a ratio, but we could have an offset so that as we move channel 1, we would see channel 2 move with that same offset. Another feature is we can also couple amplitude. So let me go ahead and turn on amplitude coupling. It's an independent setting, but as you can see with the amplitude coupling on, when I go back and change the amplitude of channel 1, the amplitude of channel 2 changes. We also have a couple special cases for coupling the channels, and that is using the tracking feature. And so with tracking on, what it does is it produces 2 identical signals, and they're both in phase. And so as you can see, we now have 2 identical signals that, that copied the waveform, the amplitude, and the frequency. And the other special tracking mode we have is to invert it, so it's 180 degrees out of phase, and this is useful for creating a differential signal, so the two channels can be combined to create a single differential channel. Moving on to the third method, we're going to use the optional IQ player. So the optional IQ player can actually be used to play back any two-channel waveform, and so we're going to go ahead and show what that looks like. So in Excel, the way it would look is we'd have in column A, we'd have all the data for channel 1, and in column B, we'd have all the data for channel 2. And so each row would represent a data pair. And so what we're going to send to the function generator is these data pairs in a CSV file. So I'm going to go ahead and save the Excel spreadsheet as a CSV file to USB stick. And then we can import the data from our USB stick. So I'll go ahead and show you what that looks like. So we'll go ahead and go to waveforms, go to ARBs, and then I'm going to go ahead and import the data. So I'll select the data file, which is out on my USB stick. So I'll select it. And then I'm going to select to bring in the data as an IQ waveform, even though it's not an IQ waveform. But this allows the data pairs to be imported. And I'm going to import my data. Okay, so now we've imported our data. I'm gonna say yes, we wanna load the file. And I'm gonna auto-scale the oscilloscope so we can see both waveforms. And as you can see, I have a sine wave on channel one, and I have a sine wave at twice the frequency on channel two. So this could be used to represent a mechanical system with a gear ratio of 2:1. And so with this special option, when I change the amplitude, I change the amplitude for both data pairs simultaneously. If I change the sample rate or frequency, I change it for both channels. So this is one more method of creating data that's synchronized with a two-channel waveform generator. So we looked at three different methods to synchronize waveforms using the new 33500B series from Agilent. We started by setting up the two channels independently and then using the sync internal function. The second method was to use channel coupling. So the advantage to that was when we changed the frequency on the first channel, the second channel moved with it. In addition, we could do the same thing with amplitude, and we looked at the special case modes for tracking. We created the identical signal and the inverted signal. And then we moved on to the IQ player, which is optional, and downloaded our data pairs and created two synchronized waveforms using the optional IQ player. So these are very unique features to the 33500B. I hope you found this useful. Thanks for watching.